Let's take a look at a direct materials budget example. So the problem says Martin Company has the following production budget for the first 3 months of 2020 in that chart given to us. Then some additional information for us. Each unit requires 4 pounds of raw materials costing $3 per pound. On December 31st, 2019, the ending raw materials was 8,000 pounds. Management wants to have a raw materials inventory at the end of the month equal to 20% of next month's production requirements. So with all of that information, we can then prepare a direct materials purchases budget for January 2020. So we have all of the information that we need in the upper left corner. And then this is what your direct materials purchases budget will look like. So you'll notice the first line is units to be produced. So in January, there's going to be 10,000 units being produced. We got that from that table that was given to us. The next line is direct materials per unit. So this is where we take a look and see, okay, how much material is required for one unit. So it tells us in that information that we're given in the upper left that each unit requires 4 pounds of raw materials. So this is where that 4 comes into play. Now, our total pounds needed for production. Well, if we are going to produce 10,000 units and each unit needs 4 pounds of materials, we multiply those two and we see that we need 40,000 pounds for production this month. Now we want to add in our desired ending direct materials. Well, they told us that our ending materials inventory should be equal to 20% of next month's production requirements. So we need to figure out February's production requirements right now. So we take the 8,000 units that we'll be producing in February, multiply it by the 4 pounds of materials needed for each unit, and we see that February's production requirements is 32,000. So our desired ending direct materials needs to be 20% of that, or 6,400. So we'll plug that 6,400 in as our desired ending direct materials. Now, our total materials required, that's our total pounds needed for production plus our desired ending direct materials. So we get 46,400. Now we will want to subtract out our beginning direct materials. Well, they tell us in the problem that we ended December with 8,000 pounds in our raw materials inventory. That's going to be the same amount as what we started January with. So we'll plug that 8,000 in there for our beginning direct materials, subtract that from the 46,000, and we see that we need to purchase 38,400 pounds of materials. Now, the next line is cost per pound. So each pound of materials, how much is that going to cost? We see that in the upper left as $3 per pound. So if we need to purchase 38,400 pounds of materials, and each pound costs $3, we multiply those and we get our total cost of direct materials purchases of $115,200.